Dearest Happy, Jennifer, Jonathan, the communion of saints and friends, I sincerely consider this to be really my life's greatest and most humbling privilege today, to give language on your behalf and to speak our corporate feelings in my words. Thank you. We know God created us with needs only He can meet. Boris Pascal said, a God-shaped vacuum that only God Himself can fill. Most of us spent our lives trying to meet those needs, even as Christians, by working for the approval of others, by looking for worldly satisfaction, rendering us takers and users. Brent's strength is that he simply sought and found God to meet his basic needs, enabling him to invest his life in giving and creating as Jesus did. Brent is truly a branch to Jesus' vine, and I speak in the present tense because Brent is. I never came away from time spent with Brent without feeling built up, encouraged, accepted, understood, loved, challenged, energized. Even in his illness, we came away from the hospital and recently his home, having received far more than we were able to give. His delight is to celebrate God's acceptance by giving without fear from his overflow. As another friend of ours has said, Brent is a voice and not an echo. He has a way of always seeing past what is to what God shows him can be, past the human perspective to God's eternal perspective. This week at a leadership training meeting in L.A., we were disturbed by a car alarm that went on for over half an hour right under our window. It was incredibly irritating, but then in the midst of the noise, the clouds lit up the sky above us, and the thunder of heaven followed, reminding us all that what seems most problematic, most irritating, most important at the moment, even the worst the enemy and our frail bodies are allowed to do, is nothing compared to the awesome, magnificent power and purpose of God. Paul said, "For I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us." Brent certainly heard the alarms and worked to care for the needs, but he is a man who also hears the thunder. In light of eternity, even death is a temporary irritant. It's loud and unnerving, terrible and tearful, but nothing compared to the thunder of resurrection. Today, Brent bows in awe and joy before the throne of thunder, even as we gather to bring closure to the false alarm of death, celebrating its defeat. I've known Brent for almost 24 years and easily remember when I ordained him with Larry Myers and later Bill Dwyer. He and Happy had been coming up from Orange County for several months to be a part of what we were doing, his gifts and character easily making room for him. I told them I didn't know whether we could pay them or whether they'd have to pay us.